We're here at Mills Creek Reservoir near Stewart's Draft. This is the last stop on our summer series exploring some of Virginia's smaller public lakes. And we'd heard the water was low, and it is. It's been drawn down for some repair work on the dam. We started at Lexington Reservoir, which is a hike to bike to trout reservoir. We figured it'd be kind of interesting to kind of go full circle, come back and finish at a hike to bike to lake with trout. And it looked like we were gonna have a rainy day too. It was raining this morning, but now the weather's turning pretty nice and it's gonna be pretty pleasant out there. So I'm eager to get in the water and see what we can catch. As we've done at our previous trips to trout lakes this year, we're using a simple attractor rig. This rig is what caught 3 trout in Lexington Reservoir on our first trip of the year, and many more trout on Skidmore Lake about a month and a half ago. Unfortunately, most of those trout were undersized, almost all of them. But we'd like to catch a few decent sized fish in here today. We're gonna give it a shot, so time to go do some trolling. Here's the first fish of the day. It's a brook trout, and I think it's probably about 11 inches long. It's pretty nice and fat. They're stocked in here as fingerlings, so they want you to take them out, and we're gonna happily oblige with that. That's what they're here for, is put, grow, and take, and we're gonna take. I'm actually kind of cold, so I'm gonna enjoy warming up on the bike ride back down the mountain, and we're on to Cole's Run. We'll see how that goes. Well, we're now at Cole's Run Reservoir, which is real near the last place we fished, Mills Creek. And it's a little shorter trek in here, about a half a mile. We got in and there are signs that say no swimming. So even though there's a rope swing 10 feet away from me right now, we didn't want to get in the water with the float tube, so we're gonna bank fish for a while. The water's pretty deep close to the bank here, so we're close to trout. We're gonna give it a shot. It's beautiful up here. The water's crystal clear, which is an indication that the lake actually isn't that fertile, but there are good numbers of trout in here. They're stocked in here as fingerlings, and they grow up to good size, 8 to 14 inches. So we'll see if maybe we can connect with one here in the next hour or so. We're not going to spend all day here, but we'll give it a shot.
Man, this water is so clear.
A little over 2 months ago, Sam Dean and I set out to explore some of Virginia's lesser known small public lakes. And this summer we've had a great time. We went to 10 lakes, some of them near, some of them far, some small, some of them pretty big. We've had good fishing, we've had bad fishing, we've had quite a bit of fishing in between. We've met some very interesting people. And I think ultimately what we come out of it knowing is that Virginia's got a lot of hidden treasures that we often forget about because we're so busy fishing at the big well-known lakes like Smith Mountain Lake and Carr Reservoir and Lake Anna, and little places like Cole's Run Reservoir here. They're really worth exploring, and I'd like to think that people who read the series and watched the videos that we produced and Sam worked on might be inspired to go check out some of the places we went to, but also inspired to pull out a map and look at a county near where they live and say, I wonder what that place is like, and go check it out. Some of these places we'll go back to, some we won't, but that's part of the fun of exploring.